Anti-Semitism that exists in the Christian world and the world in general to supplant it, a kind of a conspiracy theory. Those kinds of views do not exist in classical Islamic texts. Anti-Semitism that exists in the Muslim world today, and it's very important to understand this contextually, is an import. It came into the Muslim world in the 19th century on the heels of colonialism. European colonial powers, obviously Christian colonial powers, brought Western-type Christian anti-Semitism into the Muslim world. This kind of anti-Semitism grew as the struggle between Arab nationalism and Jewish nationalism came to the fore. It became exacerbated in the 20th century as the establishment of a Jewish state in Israel seemed to be looming in the near future, and it has become extremely serious since the establishment of the State of Israel and the ongoing Israeli occupation, and it has become Islamized. What do I mean by that? Whereas this kind of anti-Semitism comes from the West, Muslims have sought to make it their own by citing Islamic texts which express a view of the Jews which is similar to the views expressed in Western Christian anti-Semitism. The problem that they have is that there are very few classical Arabic texts that fit the mold. Very few. And so they use the same ones over and over again. Nonetheless, it seems like anti-Semitism is indigenous genetic in the Islamic religion. And that frightens people, it frightens Israelis, it frightens American Jews. It seems to be something very old. What's important to know, this is where a knowledge of history can play an important part in establishing lines of communication between people, understanding where this anti-Semitism comes from and how it is related to problems that exist in the present, can help people divest themselves of the belief that it's an irradical thing. Now, disturbingly, equally disturbingly, on the other side, Jews, whether in Israel or outside of Israel, have developed attitudes towards Arabs and Muslims, and remember that not all Muslims are Arabs and not all Arabs are Muslims, attitudes which are similar to the anti-Semitic attitudes that are rife in the Islamic world. These are attitudes that are prejudicial, that belittle Muslims. These attitudes may